there are a lot of hazards for like the habitat systems on the surface of the Moon or Mars. Thermal fluctuations, cosmic radiations, meteorite impacts, and seismic activities. So that's why we are introducing a new idea of building these habitat systems inside the lava tubes. Lava tubes form as the lava channels flow on the surface of the ground. Gradually, they form a tube and they form a very hard and a strong crust on top. They can provide immediate shelters against those surface hazards, and they can be used for permanent future habitat systems. There are like physical evidences of the existence of the lava tubes under the moon's surface. There are some vertical holes or skylights, and with the shadow measurements, they show that there is some like natural openings underneath them. The largest size that they have measured for the lunar lava tubes, the width is in the order of 1 to 2 kilometers wide and several hundreds of kilometers in the length. So they are much larger than the lava tubes that we see here. We cannot yet visit the lava tubes on the Moon or Mars, but there are a lot of things that we can learn by visiting those on Earth. So we visited Bobet National Monument in California. We spent like maybe 5 hours each day inside that lava tube. For each cross section, we created a 3D point cloud model by just using the images collected to reconstruct those lava tubes. We can use all this collected data to better assess the size and the structural stability of the lava tubes as future habitat systems on the Moon and Mars. I see a lot of good feedbacks whenever I present about our work into like a space conferences, because I think this is one of the first times that a group of researchers from civil engineering, geomechanical engineering, they are deeply looking into fundamental things about living on the Moon or Mars. If I can see that during my lifetime, that's gonna be very interesting. And we can say in our research group, we have had like a very good contribution to this research.